The national vaccination drive will be launched tomorrow ahead of the subsequent distribution of the vaccine in the districts across the country. This was revealed by the Minister for ICT and National Guidance, Judith Dabakova.
The Ministry of Health has commenced the training exercise of vaccinators who will be administering the vaccines at various service points. The vaccination centers will include government health center 3s and 4s, district hospitals, regional and national referral hospitals, and specialized institutions countrywide. While addressing journalists on the cabinet decisions taken during the special meeting held on March 3rd, Nabakoza said the vaccination exercise will begin on March 10th.
And I think even when the lockdown was lifted, things started normalizing, and we hope they will normalize now with the introduction of a vaccine.
She stressed that all those who are to be vaccinated will have to sign a consent form, stressing that nobody will be forced to be vaccinated. Uganda received the first batch of 864,000 doses of AstraZeneca vaccine on Friday. The country targets to vaccinate 49.6% of the population, which is about 21,936, in a phased manner. Each phase is planned to cover 20% of the population, which is about 4,387,202 people. The eligible population lies in the range of 18 years and above. According to the cabinet decisions, all persons eligible for vaccination will be required to provide a national identification card for Ugandans and a passport for non-Ugandans. Those are foreigners and refugees. Vaccinated persons will also receive vaccination cards, which will be required for the second dose. Nabakoza said all health workers from public, private, not-for-profit and private health facilities will be the first group to receive the vaccine given the nature of work, followed by teachers as a special category as the second group. The third group will be persons above 50 years of age, while the other group will be persons aged 18 to 50 years with underlying health conditions like hypertension, diabetes, cancer, organ diseases such as liver, kidney and heart disease. Story compiled by Jeff Andrew Lule for the news.